etabo, 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 etabo. Thank you, sir. We are grateful to you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Our miracle governor is in the house. Can we celebrate him? We will not be here if not for our miracle governor. Can we celebrate him? We cannot do without the beautiful women of Bayelsa. Can we celebrate all of them? And lastly, can you celebrate yourself today? Celebrate yourself. Is that the way you can celebrate yourself? Come on, clap your hands and celebrate yourself. Today is a great day in God's presence. We are here to celebrate God for the great things He is doing.
Come on. from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer my foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. Verse 8. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. This is the word of the Lord.
And it is He who gives us deliverance.
do everything that we do, the big and the small, to get an answer. And I'm particularly delighted to be here on this 12th edition. And that was why I got the invitation, as I always do. My wife and I decided to be here. No matter the name, those invitations have to wait. I will not be here to join all of you, and with all of you, join the government and the government of our cities to give thanks to God. It is a miracle, isn't it? That this is the 12th edition. When we started this, people thought, like some of those things, it will come and it will go. There were those who said, oh, when if I lost the 2015 my re-election due, that all these things will start. Again, that will not happen. And 2020, when we started the transition, the successful transition, and our father is here and he knows a lot more. He will teach all of us. He has enough in his pocket to teach us. Re-election is tough, but transition to something else is out of this world. Completely out of this world. It is only when you have done it that you can say yes. You have some experience. I used to tell my colleagues, if you are a governor and you go for the election, the election is tough. When you win, you become a juice. But when you do transition, and God helps you and you win with your head intact, and you go back home and sleep, then you qualify to call yourself a general. A general. And also, when you manage that successor, the good, the bad, and the ugly, in one piece, and your state intact, and your people peaceful, and the government and people and the state stable, like we are doing. So today, I want to thank all of you for coming. I can see our people peaceful. I can see, as you all know, that we are on a steady course of development. And after this event, I will join the government and our father to commission all of the important roads, the central territorial road, which I took to a degree as people can feel the earth, and our honor is continuing. That's what we want for our people. So we want for our people. So on this Thanksgiving Day, my family and I are grateful to all of you, grateful to our God, grateful to the team working with the government, grateful to all the good people of our state, and most of all, grateful to God Almighty for His blessings. And it is our prayer that our state will continue to witness stability and peace and development in Jesus' name. Yeah. It's our prayer that this knowledge and awareness of God get you, don't get me wrong, not perfection. For no man is flesh and the perfect. Not perfection, but an awareness of the divine. The need to continue connecting with that divine. That was what we used to do. That's what the government and the team are continuing to pray the Lord. I want to thank the religious team. All of you, almost all of you, were part of our religious team. And now also supporting the government. The government and the team to carry on all the doctrines, religious aspects that we used to do. Government and the team. I thank you, government. And your team, for not just continuing with this annual Thanksgiving, which is by law, but the tradition of morning devotion, starting the day with an awareness of the presence of God,
and our eyes on Him. That's tradition, not perfection. The government is continuing with it. I instituted prayer night, one evening every month. One evening every month. The government and the city are also continuing with the pastor. And then this hammer can feel it. So, I wish you well, our team. I wish our faith well. And the God, the good Lord that has brought all of you in one piece, will take you all back home, including me and my delegation. You will come with me. John Kennedy, man of God, why is he not coming with me? And my colleague, Senator Sonny Masaka, too. And all that you came with me. God will take all of you and take all of us also. Back to the destination of Jesus' name. Finally, the God answer our prayers and accept our offerings of thanksgiving in Jesus' name. God bless you all.
A round of applause for him, a round of applause for him. The man who saw the vision and transcended the vision. And of course, Henry Serake Dixon. Next, I'd like to invite working with him. He came back again and nurtured Nigeria's Third Republic, which is still thriving up to today. It is my pleasure, Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, to invite a man who is not just a father to his family, not just a father to his state, he's not just a father to Nigeria, he's a father of Africa, one highly recognized and appreciated all over the world. It is my pleasure now to invite our former president, His Excellency, Chief Olusegun Matthew Okikiola Ogunboye, and remove Obasanjo DCFR, former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. It is 6 years old, and you can see me very strong. Shall we put it down together for him? Very strong, very humble, very godly.
And was just a little Jacob, please lead us in prayer. And allow the Lord to give us a price. God, and said, I have given you my word in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So you sat down. I am giving you my word, but I want to sit down. Then, look at your moving up to you. First, I thank God for this occasion that I am able to do this and for being able to worship in this splendid auditorium. You know that all sense of music is a imitator. And a very good imitator. And if you try, I comprehend you. But you know better, as you make that, as you die.
I'm a fire man. If
what we have happening here is replicated in all other states of Nigeria. Then we will say we have a good government. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Your Excellency. His Excellency, former President Olusegun Aremu Obasanjo. Please a round of applause for him again, thank you. Not just strong and vibrant at 86.
Praise him for the gift of life,
praise you for breaking his head. Praise you for his senses. Praise you for everything that is for us. In your glory. Father, we praise you and exalt you. We rather the Father, we can exalt you above the heavens. And above the heavens, above everything created, this is our nature. But I ask the King of power, group, all the worship, all the rest, in that we exalt you forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Heavenly Father, the Father of all spirits, the living and the true God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the covenant to be God. About whose Son has made and called us, thank you for bringing us before you in these 2 days of anniversary of thanks for the time given for this very service. May I make a sort of a praise for you. But we look up on the heaven and pray as we have come before you once again. Bless our souls. Make us that which you want us to be. Transform everyone. And I pray for help at last for everyone in Jesus' name. Once again, I pray, as for this place, bless this church more and more. And bless all that can attend us in this program. Bless His excellencies. Let the name be glorified. Holy Ghost, take over. Thank you very, very much. In Jesus' powerful name, we pray.
We should do all that.
prophecies are not exorcisms, but they shall be fulfilled. Praise the Lord. Because of time also, drawn from the blessings of grace, the cup is in on the deep, blessed are you. Praise the Lord. Blessed are you. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor, to know that you are blessed. You are blessed people. You are blessed from the foundation, from the beginning of this world, by the Most High God. He has blessed this planet with great mineral resources. He has made blessed this land with such as oil, gas, and sea, with all blessings that made this land with peace and unity. I want to let you know we are blessed. Praise the Lord. Christ is like a promised land. We take good looking bestowed by God Almighty in it. Our blessing God by the others. God has given us everything in this land and that it was very careful. One has to do and no one in this land. Because the blessings that you are giving to us, that is what I said this foundation on the 12th of our dear Lord, we have come to celebrate, we are going to thank you, we are going to dedicate everything about this said to God. Because Lord Almighty has blessed us. And confidence and everything about us was supposed to be called to me. Praise the Lord. So, I want to talk briefly on the following points. The readings, evidences of blessings. Two, our special response and evidence. Praise the Lord. And look at the readings and evidences of his blessings. Well, why I do not know what he or she has, such person cannot appreciate nor preserve such a thing. And then, I want to let you know, who do not know what they have not chosen this. Praise the Lord. So, I want to come aside. I mean, you do not know what you have. You have just spent half of those things all. But now realizing what God has given you, he has to bring his sonship. Because you cannot appreciate what you do not know and have. And the Bible says in Hosea chapter 4, verse 6, my people are sorry about all. About the time of the cross, of knowledge that the access we have in calling this passing, the Lord is breaking the Lord. But if you hear it here, that the access know what they have, hence this occasion to break the time to break and be the daily steps the Lord of Christ. I want to let you know of this. What can I do to God? What can I do to us? You're welcome, sir. Former president of this country. You're welcome, sir. My dear wife, my very supportive, ever-walking, resourceful deputy governor, and your wife, and our foundation lady governor, your human being. We did it back from all of our states. Now we see the Senate Club. And we are very supportive wife and dear sister. Members of the National Assembly who are here in numbers, leaders and elders of this country and our states, Bayelsa. I cannot call them one by one. I will say that to tomorrow. You are very many. I acknowledge all of you. All of you. Thank you for coming. My Lord, spiritual. My brothers and sisters in Christ. Members of the Father State of America. Manoa, today I am not going to give an address. My address is to praise God and to thank God. By our God's, the life of this administration, to another November 2nd, which is the last year of the first term of this government. And we are all alive from the man who had ever been to me, his family, my family, except for my father, who of course left at the age that God has set for him. Let me use this opportunity once again to thank Your Excellency, the former President, who came all the way to come and honor my father. And today you are here again to honor us. Thank you, sir. May you be the honor of my father. Let me tell you this. You know, former president is always giving me to jokes. I went to him to appreciate him for coming all this long to come and attend the funeral rites of my father. And can you guess what he told me? Can you guess? Now, after thanking him, he said, Governor, that's the way he used to call Governor. In fact, after attending your father's burial, in fact, he died hungry in you. People are honored, fathers are honored upon death, then I have nothing to do again. Let me go so you go can honor me. And I didn't think you in my knowledge of life, so you cannot be us now. So thank you, sir. We appreciate you now and always. And for